The coroner has heard the skipper of a South Australian abalone boat failed to raise the alarm after watching two great white sharks maul his diver. Alice Monfreaks has been at the inquest in Port Lincoln. She joins us now live. Alice.
Well, Beck, the court heard it took at least 3 hours before emergency services were even told about the shark attack. And the skipper's confusion as to the exact location made a rescue search very difficult. Known as Peter Perfect, Peter Clarkson was a highly experienced abalone diver with a love of the deep. He died while diving near Coffin Bay in February 2011, reportedly taken by sharks. An inquest has begun into his death, harrowing for his family.
It's not an easy day for us, just reliving the events of 2.5 years ago.
Coroner Mark Johns heard Mr. Clarkson's skipper, Howard Rodd, witness the shark attack, the second time he's lost a colleague at sea while diving in South Australian waters. Investigating officer Detective Sergeant Anthony Boots told the court Mr. Rodd had many options to raise the alarm, but used none. He failed to activate his emergency beacon, radio for help, drop a marker buoy, press a man overboard button, or use his mobile phone. Detective Sergeant Boots saying it made a search like looking for a needle in a haystack, and we hadn't quite found the haystack yet. Counsel assisting the coroner said Mr. Rodd eventually made 3 phone calls when he returned to shore 3 hours later, but none to emergency services. He contacted Western Abalone Processors, his lawyer, his accountant and his son. Mr. Rodd also took his abalone catch to the processing plant before a full investigation could be carried out. By the time police were notified by paramedics, Mr. Rodd's boat was on the back of a trailer kilometres away. It's hard to believe this preoccupation with compliance to the Fisheries Act could trump the preservation of evidence in a death, the coroner said. Mr. Clarkson's family disappointed it took so long for emergency services to be notified, but not angry.
No, I 100% believe what Howard has told us. Just closure, basically, for us, just to be able to finally, you know, lay him to rest.
Now, the skipper, Mr. Rodd, won't give evidence until Thursday. Tomorrow, the inquest will hear from the two men he first contacted on coming back into shore, as well as a passerby who helped him on the beach. Beck?
Thank you, Alice. Alice Monfreaks, live from Port Lincoln.